Hi friends, today I'm going to tell you about something which is an observation in my clinical practice and I call it the bag ache. No, it's not the back ache, it's called the bag ache. When people come to my clinic and complain of back ache, I started observing that most of them were females, also that most of them were either working or were carrying loads, their household stuff, maybe things which they have to transfer from one place to another. I started wondering why. And when I myself developed this bag ache, a huge problem, I realized that it should be addressed, and sooner the better, because it is something which we can totally avoid. Now there is first thing which I would like to tell you, that never carry a bag of more than 250 grams in a suspended manner. For example, if you are suspending the bag with your hand and holding the strings in your hand, then the weight of the bag should not be more than 250 grams. You should keep switching the sides. If you hold it in the right hand for some time, shift it to your left side. If the weight is little more, and if you have to move fast, you have to jog, you have to run, or you have to rapidly catch a local train or anything like that, then try to put it in a cross. A diagonal strip of the bag is really going to help you to divide the weight in an equal manner. If the heavy part of the bag is on your side and it brings a problem in walking or running, then move it to the front, and that makes it very comfortable. You can again switch the side from one to the other, and then you don't feel the burden of it. Now let me come to the heavy weights of bags which we are carrying every day, the laptop bags, the bags of books. So this is very important because all our students are doing this. So there is a very common practice to wear the bag on the strips here and suspending the weight on the bag. Now if you look at the shape of your bag, you will realize that we have got a beautifully curved spine, and that weight which we hold in the bag actually hurts our spine. So if you feel that the weight is not being comfortably carried by you or is causing you to bend in front, in all such situations, make sure you put the weight side on the front and the straps on the back. How does it help you? It helps us because we tend to walk in the front, and when we move in the front, the weight of the bag does not add load to our body, rather it moves ahead and helps us in walking. Another thing which is very important is that whatever you contain in your bag, there should be a soft cushion between you and whatever is being carried in the bag. If, for example, you have books, you have laptops, they are pretty hard. And if they hurt any part of your body constantly for hours together every day, they are definitely going to create an effect. And so what you should do is that the side of the bag which is going to touch your body should have a soft cushion. If it has an inbuilt cushion, it's fine. If it doesn't have, then you can put some folded cloth or some sponge material or some cotton material in such a way that it doesn't hurt you. Now, if you are not careful about this bag load and you start feeling the discomfort, the stretch, the muscle pull, even the pain, then you understand and get alarmed. It is going to take you a long way because bag aches are very difficult to handle. If we go to a physiotherapist or if we go to a naturopathist, for the treatment of this kind of a bag ache, they are first going to relax your back muscles. Can you do it yourself? Of course, application of stretch and heat help to relax. And so, if you are supposed to carry weight on your back or you have the kind of back ache, then stretch yourself. Pull your arms, stretch at the top, in the bottom, or I would suggest practice Surya Namaskar for 10 times in the morning. And if you do that, your muscles are rejuvenated, they are enhanced, and the stress is relieved. It's a cool movement. The back is beautiful. Do you know what makes humans so superior to other animals? Yes, of course, it is a beautiful back, besides this hand, which is so freely flexible. And if we have this bag ache, the first structure of our body which gets affected is the shoulder and then the hand. And so our efficiency gets affected. People start having heaviness in this part, they start developing numbness, and then this is an endless process. And God forbid, if you have changes in your spine, then you have to definitely consult a physician. But sooner or later, if you get rid of all the bad habits, you adapt a good back posture, and then you adapt good relaxation techniques, along with a rich meal, a lot of water that help your muscles to be spongy and active and flexible, you will not get this bagging. And in case you get the bagging, you'll get rid of it. So please be careful about your back, because it's going to help you move ahead in your life and carry things in a beautiful manner. Praying for everybody's good times, and nobody should have a bag A. Bye-bye for now.